Yes, there might have been some shitty stuff that has happened to you in the past. Granted, and you don't have to forget about that. But from this point onward, the only thing stopping you from succeeding is you. You and you making poor decisions. Welcome back, everyone. My name is Hamish Hodder, and today I want to talk about the three things that are holding you back from becoming rich. Now, this video was inspired by Ryan Scribner, who did a video similar to this in collaboration with Dan Lok. So I thought I would make my own video and talk about the three things that I think are holding you back from becoming rich or financially independent. Subscribe if you enjoy, and let's get into it. Number one for today of things that are holding you back from becoming rich is you're not buying cash producing assets. Now, for most people, they spend their income the exact same way. Their income comes in usually from a 9-to-5 job, and they spend it on two different things, two different categories: liabilities and expenses. So expenses is, well, everyone knows what expenses are. We're talking about your rent, your utility bills, any kinds of those things, your phone bills. That's where your money goes. And that's unavoidable usually. I mean, you can limit the amount of money that goes to your expenses, but we'll talk about that in just a second. But spending money on expenses, living expenses, that is inevitable. But the problem here is that they then spend the rest of their money on liabilities. Now, a liability is something that when you buy it, it continues to take money away from you, take money out of your pocket. It's something that takes money out of your pocket over the long term. And a good example of this is a car. So most people will go out, they'll buy a car, and then you need to pay for gas, you need to pay to service that car, you might need to replace it in 5 or 10 years. These are all outflows of money from your pocket because you've bought that thing. Another example would be something like a Netflix subscription. Every single month, if you want to continue watching, you need to pay $15 to Netflix. That's a liability. It's taking money out of your pocket. Now, I'm certainly not saying that you shouldn't buy a car or have the luxury of having a $15 Netflix subscription. But what I'm talking about here is that you can't shovel all of your money into expenses and liabilities. You need to take a proportion of your money and buy cash producing assets. And the way that you can do this is by what you might have heard of before, which is called paying yourself first. Now, a lot of people throw this term around and they never explain what it actually means. So I'm gonna explain it to you so that it makes complete sense to you. Because I remember the first few times that I heard this, pay yourself first, I just took it for granted. I was like, yeah, okay. But I never really thought about it that much. But when you think about it, it makes sense. So instead of paying your bills, which is paying the person who owns your building, your rent, the utility companies, instead of paying Netflix first, instead of paying the car company or the petrol pump, you should pay yourself, which means you put a certain amount of money aside and you buy cash producing assets. And when you do that, when you put a certain percentage of your income aside before you pay for all of those things, it becomes like your own personal tax. So you just tax yourself. And like the example that a lot of people give is that if the government raised taxes by 10% tomorrow, you would hate it, but you would pay it. So why can't you just tax yourself 10% and put that 10% of money into cash producing assets? And a cash producing asset is exactly the opposite of a liability. It's something that when you buy it, it continues to put money in your pocket. So if you make a real estate investment, that is a cash producing asset, because every single month, if you have a tenant in that property, they're going to pay you rental income. That is cash inflows that you receive from that asset. Another example would be if you invested in a business on the stock market, and that business can pay you in a couple of different ways. It could pay you a direct cash dividend. It could pay you a dividend that is more stock, but that's still an inflow of positive benefit for you, that you're receiving more stock of that company. Or the value of that company could increase, and therefore the value of the stocks that you own increase and your net worth increases. These are all things that put money in your pocket. And this is a major difference between what rich people do and what poor people do. By setting aside a proportion of your income to buy cash producing assets, your income will grow exponentially, because your income isn't just coming from your 9-to-5 job anymore. You're getting your major income from your 9-to-5 job, but now you've got a little bit of rental income here. you've got a bit of dividends coming in here. You've got your stocks that are appreciating here, and the value of that property is also appreciating here. And what will happen is that over time, you can get to a point in which your assets are paying you enough money to cover your living expenses. And what we call that is financial freedom. You would no longer need to work that 9-to-5 job in order to live, because the assets that you've bought over time, over your lifetime, you've bought some stock here, you've bought a property here, you've bought this and this and this, over time, those devices, those assets are bringing you in enough money to pay for your rent, your utilities, and even maybe your $15 Netflix subscription. And that is called financial freedom, financial independence. And it means that you can then spend your time doing what you want, and whether that's to create even more passive income streams or whether that's to do something completely different. Number two of things that are holding you back from becoming rich is that you're not leveraging your skills. So again, let's go back to the average person. So the average person, as I said in the last number, was that they get a 9-to-5 job. And how they do that is you finish high school, you go to university, and you get yourself an expensive piece of paper that says you know something. And you use that piece of paper to get a job that you hate, and then you work that job for the rest of your life and you hate yourself. And there's no way that you can increase your income drastically. You can increase your income a little bit because maybe you get a promotion and you get paid an extra $5,000 a year, good on you. Or maybe you get a $1,000 raise, well done, you've made an extra $1,000 this year. Or you could just somehow work more hours, because you're usually getting paid hourly if you're in a 9-to-5 job. So you could work more hours. But again, that is limited. There's only so many hours in the day you can work. And who wants to spend 80 hours a day working on something that you hate? What most people miss about rich people is that in order to make more income, you don't need to do more of your hourly job. You need to leverage your skills. And that means that not working for someone else, it means you need to work for yourself. And what do I mean by work for yourself? It means that instead of just rocking up to your work and working for someone else tells you what to do and they tell you how much you're going to get paid. You just go out into the world, you look at your skills, and you find an area that you know quite a bit about. You find a painful problem in that area and you solve it. And by solving that problem, you can package it into a product or service that provides a ton of value, and you can sell that to people yourself. You can be the owner of the company. You don't have to be one of the minions that is being bossed around and getting paid $15 an hour. The real power of leveraging your skills is that you're not bound by time. So let me just show you, like, my YouTube, for example. Let's give you my YouTube for an example. So I can teach thousands of people how to invest in the stock market by creating one video. I make one video, it might take me 4 or 5 hours to make that video. I put it up on the internet, and then thousands of people can watch that. And the result of that is that it's packaged in a way that everybody wins. So I create the contents once, I don't need to work, I don't need to slave away. I slave away for 5 hours, but it's fun, I like doing it. So I do that for 5 hours. It's free on YouTube, so everyone can watch it for free. Everyone loves that. Everyone loves free stuff. And advertisers love it because thousands of people are watching it and they can pay to have a little ad at the front of this video in order to get some exposure. And the result of that is that everybody wins. So the viewer wins because they learn a solution to their problem for free, completely free. They just click on the video, watch it, and they've learned exactly what they want to learn. The advertiser wins because they can chuck an ad at the start, and a few of those thousand people who are watching it will go onto their website and buy products for them. So the advertiser wins. And I win because I just make I spend five hours making a video, and I get paid by the advertiser for it. I think a lot of people have this misconception out there about business, that business is just a fancy way of saying that you should go out and scam people. Don't scam people. I'm not saying that at all. I'm saying that you should just provide a ton of value for a small price. If you solve someone a problem that saves them $100,000 and you charge $5,000 for that problem, that's a win-win. You get $5,000 for solving that problem and they save $95,000 because they save $100 and they spend $5. So they save $95. That's a win-win. That's not a scam. That's both parties mutually agreeing to a transaction and winning. And the more painful the problem that you can solve, if you can solve a really big painful problem for a lot of people, then you will make a lot of money. And number three today of things that are holding you back from becoming rich is that you don't take responsibility for yourself. So most people, well, okay, let me start here. Everyone is born into a different situation with positive and negatives. And some people are born into situations with a lot of negatives. I'm not negating that at all. And some people are born into situations with a lot of positives. Everyone is born into a different situation, and that is out of our control. But what isn't out of our control is the decisions we make once we're on this planet. Most people won't become rich because they spend their entire lives blaming other people for their shitty situations. They blame their boss for not promoting them. They blame their parents for not being supportive enough and ruining their brain or something, or ruining their situation. They blame their parents for feeding them junk food and now they're in a terrible situation that they can't avoid. Oh, it's just poor me. I'm in a terrible situation because of all the things that have happened to me. Or some people even blame the government for charging too many taxes or not giving them enough benefits. And these people are in constant blame mode, and they don't realize that they have the power to control every decision that they make from that point onward. Yes, there might have been some shitty stuff that has happened to you in the past, granted, and you don't have to forget about that. But from this point onward, the only thing stopping you from succeeding is you. You and you making poor decisions. Successful people take responsibility for what is wrong with them, even if it's not their fault in the first place. They take responsibility for what's wrong with them, and they take steps to fix it. And that is the most important thing. If you just start taking steps towards fixing the things you don't like in your life, it doesn't matter if you didn't cause those things. If you just take responsibility and say, I don't care that all that stuff happened to me in the past. From this point onward, I'm taking control. I'm gonna do this instead of this. I'm gonna eat healthy instead of eating that junk food. I'm gonna go exercise instead of doing that. I'm gonna get up tomorrow morning and work on my business instead of lying in bed and watching Netflix. Those are the decisions that are up to you. No one is stopping you except yourself, and successful people work this out early and it compounds over time. It becomes easier to fix problems about yourself the more you do it, and you start with smaller problems and you start building up and up and up. And eventually you're just looking for things about yourself that are even slightly off, and you fix it. And then you become this amazing person that can do anything you can set your mind to. And you have all these aspirations. And if you just slowly chip and chip and chip away at them and start taking steps towards them, you can achieve whatever you want to achieve. And this is what rich people figure out early on in their life. And it's why they're able to become so successful. I am so grateful that this is something that I figured out so early on in my life. Just to use my personal example, if you go back for me 2 or 3 years ago, I had no aspirations. I had a terrible diet. I didn't exercise at all for maybe like 3 or 4 years. I had a terrible sleeping pattern. I'd stay up till like 4 a.m. and then sleep until midday or the afternoon. I basically did nothing. I basically just existed in a bubble and really didn't move at all. Fast forward 2-3 years now, I have an online business. I get up at 7 every morning and I go to bed and get up at the exact same time. I run nearly every single morning. I do exercise. I eat healthy. I feel a lot happier. I'm just a lot healthier in general. And I'm doing the exact thing that I want to be doing. And that's not a long amount of time, but it just took me just time to chip away at it. I just one day I was like, nah, I'm not gonna sleep in till midday today. I'm gonna get up and maybe I'll just watch a YouTube video on something that I'm interested in. And then the next day it was, all right, I'm gonna start to take action on some of the things that I want to do. And slowly but steadily, you build these habits that change you from who you were before into someone that you want to be. And it's just exponential. I mean, the amount that I get done in a day today is just, there's no comparison to what I was getting done even a year ago, or even 6 months ago, or even last month. I mean, it just compounds on itself. I mean, even like 6 months ago, I would probably work nearly every day, but I wouldn't work for long. And 6 months later, now I'm at the point where I'm getting up at 7 a.m. and I'm working pretty much every single day until 4 or 5 o'clock. So it's very quick that you can build upon yourself. And it all just comes down to making smart decisions. Just wake up in the morning and ask yourself, what decisions do I want to make today? And then make those decisions. And that is ultimately the last thing that I think changes the difference or is a massive differentiator between people who are successful and not successful, and between people who don't make a lot of money and people who do make a lot of money. So if you did enjoy this video, make sure you leave a like and let me know your thoughts on this down in the comments section below. What are some of the things that you think hold people back from becoming rich or successful? And of course, if you did enjoy this content and you want to see more, then make sure you hit subscribe and join the team and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on any of the future videos. But for now, guys, I'll see you in the next one.